Beloved friends, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the International Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. I'm just so thrilled to know that God's Word is reaching the ends of the earth. To me, it's something very, very special to know, firstly, that the return of Jesus Christ is imminent, to know that the message of the hour is the time to wake up. It's given to us as a wake-up call for all those who wish to be ready when the bridegroom comes. Then we understand that promises are being fulfilled, especially the main promise that God would send a prophet like Elijah to restore all things and to turn the hearts of the children back to the apostolic fathers, back to the beginning, back to where things have been 2,000 years ago when the New Testament church was established. And beloved friends, if you look into the scripture, we have the four gospels. They record of our Lord from his birth to his ascension to heaven. Then you have the book of Acts, giving us the record of what God has done since the outpouring of the Holy Spirit and the coming into existence of the New Testament church. Then we've got the epistles, wherein every Bible subject is dealt with, all the ministries, all the gifts, all the fruits of the Spirit, about the first resurrection, second, about the end time, all included. Finally, you have the book of the revelation of Jesus Christ, showing the very things which would come to pass in the prophetic realm. And beloved, the book that was sealed to the time of the end, according to Daniel chapter 12, verse 4, was revealed. Believe it or not, I cannot make you believe it, but I'm a witness that God has chosen Brother William Branham as a vessel in our time. And it was in March 63 that this man of God spoke on the seven seals, and he spoke in general on the subjects contained in the 22 chapters of the book of Revelation. Since that time, this book is no more the book sealed with seven seals. It's an open book, and we do have access to the various mysteries of the kingdom of God. There has never been a time on earth wherein God's plan of salvation, all the teachings and practices of the church were revealed and shown in such a marvelous way. Then, when it comes to the prophetic scripture, up till this time, people had their own explanations and interpretations, But from that time, we do have revelation upon revelation. And the Holy Spirit guides us into all the truth. Today, I like to touch on Ephesians chapter 1 and the other chapters very briefly. We have to understand by divine revelation that God, before the foundation of the earth, has chosen us in Jesus Christ, our Lord. God's plan does not have to be considered today and planned today. God planned all that would happen in the course of time from all eternity. And if we look into the scripture from Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, to the last chapter and last verse of the New Testament, we have the things which contain the creation, salvation, the whole plan of God, right from the beginning to the end. So, at the first coming of Christ, all the promises given for that time were fulfilled. And now we are living near to the return of Christ, and therefore Bible prophecies are fulfilled. Referring to Ephesians chapter 1, we are told that God has blessed us with all the heavenly blessings which were in Christ Jesus our Lord. Then in verse 4, that he has chosen us from before the foundation of the world to appear before him in glory without blame. In verse 5, having predestinated us to the adoption of sons by Jesus Christ. This is the divine purpose accomplished in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. In him, the only begotten Son, all the sons and daughters of God were placed back into their original position. We're just waiting for the changing of our bodies at the return of our Lord and Savior. In verse 9, having made known unto us the mystery of his will. It's not enough to pray, thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. No, that's not enough. Everybody, millions and billions, can pray that. But the chosen ones have the divine revelation of the mystery of the will of God, which was purposed and is accomplished through Jesus Christ our Lord. In verse 11, in whom you also have obtained an inheritance. Oh, what riches of glory are here shared with us. And then, of course, we must ask ourselves, where do we find ourselves in the Holy Scriptures? Are we here? Does God speak about you, about me? Are you included? Do you believe what the Word of God says when you read it? If you can believe it, then it's yours. If you don't believe it, you're outside of all these promises. So therefore, it's very essential to believe as the scripture says, to believe every promised word of God. And then after this, we read in verse 13, in whom ye also trusted after ye heard the word of the truth. And the word of truth is the gospel of our salvation. And then we are sealed with the Holy Spirit, a promise unto the day of our redemption. Beloved, we can go from chapter to chapter, especially to what was written to the Ephesian church. Chapter 2, verse 20, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Have you checked your foundation? Have you checked the teachings of your church? Are you going by the Apostolic Creed, which was formed in the 4th century by Athanasius and Augustine and many others? Or are you going by the true apostolic teachings? And with this, the Holy Scripture refers to the Apostle Peter, John, James, and Paul, to those men of the first century who were filled with the Holy Spirit, ordained of Almighty God, placed for a special purpose into the church of the living God. Those men could say in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 3, how that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery. By revelation. Nothing comes by knowledge. All comes by divine revelation. In verse 5, which in other ages was not made known unto the sons of men, as it is now revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. Beloved, we could go from verse to verse and share with you the precious word of God. Again, I'm asking, do you find yourself in the Holy Scriptures? Can you believe that you were ordained to eternal life from before the foundation of the world? Can you believe that God's grace has come upon your life and you received Christ as your personal Savior? But you did not stop with that experience. You went on deeper and deeper into the Word of God. Now, if we look into some of the other writings of the apostles, beloved, you will be surprised. Everything is already recorded and written in God's Word. About the end time, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1. This know ye also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. Then we're told what would be, how children would behave, what would actually be the situation in the last days. having the form of godliness, but denying the power of God. From such, turn away. Then, after the truth is revealed to us, something repeats that has always been since the days of Moses. In verse 8, we read, as Jannes and Jambres withstood Moses, so do these also resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith. You can speak about faith, you can even speak about revelation. But does your faith, your revelation, coincide with that of the apostles and prophets, with that of the early church? Then, in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1, I charge thee, therefore, before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the living and the dead, and his appearing in his kingdom, preach the word, be diligent in season, out of season, reproof, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. Beloved, let us summarize what I try to share with you today. The return of our Lord is very near. The signs of the time speak a very definite and loud language. We only need to look to the Middle East, especially to Israel, to Jerusalem, to the surrounding Arab nations, which hate Israel, which claim that Israel has no right to exist, and the holy war is continuing. We don't need to go into detail. Everybody hears the news every day. Beloved, when all these things take place, and the focus is upon Jerusalem and upon the surrounding nations, beloved, very soon, nobody will have to ask, what about Armageddon? When will it be? They will look back and say, it's all over. But before that comes, the bride of Jesus Christ from all the nations must be called out, must be separated from all that is not in agreement with the word of God. Ye, my people, come out from among them, be ye separate, says the Lord, then I shall receive you, and I will be your God, and you shall be my sons and my daughters. This is separation time. This is calling out time. It's not enough to speak about the signs of the end time. I have to tell you that God has sent Brother William Branham, as he did other prophets in the Old Testament, as he did send John the Baptist, a man sent from God with the word of God promised to God's people at that time, to prepare the way of the Lord, to make all things straight. Beloved, that was the ministry of Brother Branham in our time. He did not call to join a denomination. He was a man sent from God to call God's people out from all denominations, from all races, from all religions, from all cultures, back to the Word of God, a message of restoration of all things. And beloved, I had the privilege to know Brother Branham for 10 years, from 1955 to 1965. I drove with him in the same car, ate with him at the same table. I know William Branham was a man sent from God. I don't agree with anything that is now taking place under the end time message all over the earth. No, and again, no. I believe that William Branham was sent to take us back to the Word of God. I don't believe he started a new religion. I don't believe that he brought forth new teachings. I believe that every revelation he received is within the Holy Scriptures. A man of God is a man of God's holy word, because the word came to the prophets. So anything that is in circulation on earth, wherever it might be, that is not found in the Holy Scriptures, does not originate with William Branham. It's again an interpretation of what people attach to what Brother Branham actually said. So, beloved, be sure to believe only as the Scripture says. Always search the Scriptures if the teachings you hear are according to the Word of God. If somebody says, this is a special revelation, take him back to the word we just read. When the Apostle Paul said, by revelation he made known unto me the mystery of his will. But his will is in this book. God can never go beyond his word. If somebody goes beyond the word, God does not go with him. You have to remain within the Holy Scriptures. Every teaching, every practice must be as it is recorded in God's holy word. Beloved, as I said in the beginning, it is a privilege for me to share the precious and holy everlasting word of God with the inhabitants of the earth. And I like for you to spend eternity with me. Therefore, make sure you believe the way God's word teaches and be part of what God is doing right now. And may God bless you. May he be with you. We would be happy to hear from you. Many people from around the earth have written, and we have literature on Bible topics, always sharing the Word of God. And therefore, feel free to write us, to call us, to send an email, and we shall try to serve you the best we can in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.